Hello and welcome. Before we begin, I want to thank Hobbs and Maltea and Ketchup for helping me out with this video. Most people know that it's a good idea to grind your general before the war to get an advantage against your opponent. However, very little people know that you can do the same with Admiral, and I will show you how to do it properly in this video. The basic principle is the same as with the army. You want to fight your enemy as long as possible without actually beating him, making him retreat, or destroying his units. However, as you can imagine, it is slightly more difficult with Navy, since not wiping out enemy divisions and not sinking or damaging enemy ships are two slightly different things. So, how do we do it properly? Before I answer this question, it's good to make it clear what we actually want to grind for our Navy, which traits we need on our Admiral. So, no matter if we go heavy cruiser or light cruiser build, fleet protector is very important. Yeah, screening efficiency is more beneficial for heavy cruiser build. However, it unlocks as Lancer, which is great for both builds since it makes it much easier for our torpedoes to penetrate enemy screens and hit enemy capital ships and deal damage. Destroyer leader, yeah, very nice. Fly swatter is very good, not just for AA, but because it boosts both speed and damage on both heavy and light cruisers. Then we already have Ironside for capital ship build, for heavy cruiser build, 15% bonus is nice. But you know, for light cruisers, chance to receive critical hit -25% and then effects of critical hits -50%. Really helping your fleet to survive in naval battle. Okay, so how do we do it properly? We need a task force which consists at least 50% plus of screens, so we are getting XP towards fleet protector. We also need a fleet which is going to stay in battle for as long as possible. Therefore, we need it to not get destroyed, but also we must not put Navy or fleet in action big enough, so it would prompt the enemy to retreat. Meaning that if you have more soft attack, more ships, if you have advantage in battle, AI will automatically start retreating, and then, you know, the whole process of searching the enemy will start from the scratch. While we want the battle to go on for as long as possible, for months even. The way to do it is to make small task forces of destroyers and submarines. Destroyers for fleet protector and submarines because, well, they can survive for quite long time. It's important that you don't put more than 5 destroyers for submarines into a task force. Maybe 6 and 5 could do the job as well. I'm not sure about it, I didn't test it. But you really must take into consideration the fact that you are running a risk that the enemy would retreat. And also, if you have a lot of destroyers, they have very shitty guns, they have very small light attack, they have just one rapid fire gun, but still, if you get a lot of destroyers, they will just deal damage, and you don't want it, since then you either sink a ship and you have no one to fight against, or you prompt the fleet to retreat and go into repairs for a long period of time. We also do not want any capital ships in the build, not just because they have more light attack or they could sink at the enemy, but also once you get a capital ship in a battle, AI will automatically retreat. Or not AI, but the Greek AI will automatically retreat since their navy is quite small. So back to the theme, we got our task force. And it's very important we put it on always engage, for simple reason. Like this, our ships will not avoid picking a fight with enemy fleet, and also because we are on purpose taking a battle from disadvantaged position, so enemy does not retreat, we must make sure that our own navy will not retreat as well. The idea is that you wait for everyone to join the battle. If submarines start fighting first, which is unlikely because destroyers have high spotting, you just wait for destroyers to join the battle and then immediately click on do not engage. Like this, destroyers will start retreating from the battle, hence stop taking damage, and also they will technically stay in the battle while only submarines will be fighting, meaning that this battle will drag on for months and your admiral will all the time be taking more and more XP, not just over straits but also leveling up. When you're doing it, it's very important that you research smoke generators. It's because when destroyers are retreating, well, they have very little HP and you risk that they will get damaged, or that wouldn't be a problem, but in worst case scenario, they will get sank. And if you lose just one destroyer, it's a problem, because to get XP towards fleet protector, you need to have a majority of your fleet made of screens. So losing just one destroyer means that the ratio between destroyers and submarines will be exactly 50%, hence no XP towards fleet protector. If it happens, well, you have two options. Either you just add one more task force of one destroyer and let him patrol. However, it has its downsides as well. Firstly, the more task forces, the less XP you get. Secondly, if just one destroyer joins the battle, well, every single gun will be aiming at him, and there is high probability that he's gonna get sank as well, even before he manages to retreat from the battle. Time for practical demonstration. See the comments. Oh my god, you're so bad, you're not grinding anything towards fly swatter and cruiser, captain. To get these traits, you will need assistance from other players. That's a problem because on many servers this practice is banned. Basically, you need Hungary, Germany, someone to send air volunteers to Greece so he can bomb your ships. Now, you might think that I went completely crazy, but it's rather simple. If you put AA battleship with a lot of HP that can take damage and air attack and surrounded by a lot of screens or destroyers, possibly also with air attack, you're gonna be shooting down enemy planes, hence getting XP towards fly swatter. And by extension, since the task force will have more than 40% of its ships made of screens, you will be getting points towards Fleet Protector. The whole process takes, roughly speaking, 4 to 5 months, and you will have to coordinate with the air controller. So the grind is complete. We got a bit unlucky because we leveled up a lot towards positioning and not that much towards attack, which is quite important since each level gives you 5% bonus to damage output. So leveling up 7 on attack instead of positioning would be a big difference. But still, now we have an Admiral, much better than anything Brits have at their disposal. You can pick whichever traits you want, it depends on your build. If you want one more slot for trait to pick, feel free to keep grinding and make Admiral level 6, which will enable you picking one extra trait. That would be it for me for today, guys. Take care, and I'll see you next time.